Your boy Tig still in here.
Your boy Cap still in here.
And we gon' grab us a beer.
Grab a beer, grab a beer. We at the Lecture Hall. Lecture Hall. This for all of y'all. All of y'all. Lecture Hall. Lecture Hall. This for all of y'all. All of y'all. Yes. Welcome to another episode of the Lecture Hall. Hold up, anybody gotta get up and leave before we get going?
Nope, that's my bad.
All right. Good, good, good. Episode 14.
We're gonna get 14.
14. Bringing it to you, episode 14 of the Lecture Hall. Pull my socks up real quick. Getting kinda deep over here. Oh yeah.
Ain't no socks on.
Hey, we got a special guest here at the Lecture Hall.
Yeah.
Marshall's left foot.
Cross trackers. McFadden.
Yes. To his right, we got my man Richie,
Big Trucker.
Whoa,
Williams. Bringing up on the outside, our buddy, our friend, Mr. Jonathan
T.
Willard. And this is your captain speaking. Let's go ahead and get into this thing, man. People miss us. Let's go ahead and jump into this PSA. Rich, what we got for a PSA for today?
Word up, man. But know the folk been wondering, man. We've been missing for a week, man. But we back. We had to take an intermission for the you know what I'm saying, the adventures of Marshall.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Do some shopping.
Yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? Tell them about the adventures of Marshall, man. If the people didn't see it in the previous episode.
Well, in the previous episode, we all talked about you know, some things we went through, junior high, middle school, whatever the case. So I had a deal where I used to shop at Payless. And
Payless?
A situation Payless. Happened where, you know, locker room got robbed and everybody's stuff got stolen except mine, you know, and I guess where I got them from. So we wanted to go down memory lane. So the boys, they went with me and we found us a Payless. We went to a couple stores, but we finally found one.
Yeah.
And I went and purchased some shoes and I want to show y'all what they look like. They're very comfortable and they're called Cross Trackers. And the thing about these Cross Trackers, they all black.
Yeah.
You know, and the good thing about this kind of black, if they get a little ashy, you can put a little
shiny black.
Yeah, you can put a little lotion on them. You can lotion them up. You can play football in these. You can pick cars in these. You can play basketball.
And then when your prescription run out, you just go get it refilled and get another pair.
And by the way, the doctors do prescribe these.
The insoles in them things.
They got to be good, man.
They great.
The orthopedic.
Oh, yeah. Look at this.
Scrap.
Hey, get this strap.
Put it up to the mic so people can hear it.
Yeah, no lace hit. Yeah. Sound like you're tearing a piece of paper out of a notebook.
Oh, strong scratch. Strong, man. Hey, Marshall, right. Man, we appreciate you doing
that. You kept your word.
Yeah, you did, man.
No doubt, man.
Hey, it took you a while, but you know, you got it.
Yeah, you got it.
And not only that, I got a great deal on it, man. It was $16. You cannot beat it.
Hey, you can't beat that more.
You can't beat that.
Can't beat that more. But we still need to go get a pair for somebody else though.
Payless? Well, I'm gonna get my coach a pair.
Coach B,
you know, my coach a pair. He's getting up there in age.
He'll wear them too. he'll wear them. Coach Pete, what size you wear?
Yeah, we'll find out what size you need.
You got to get a Canadian size chart though.
Yeah.
So we'll find out what size, because it'd be great on his knees. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Especially working at the mill.
Yeah, at the
mill. Oh, you're right, at the mill.
Yeah, it'd be great for that. Yeah, it'd be great for that meal, man.
He might get a splint on his foot walking around them things. But it'd be good for him, though.
Yeah.
You're right.
We gonna chip in together. We gonna get him a pair. How about that, fellas?
Say no more.
It's $4 a piece.
$4 a piece.
That's it.
Yeah.
$4.
We got you, Coach Pete.
We got you.
I got five on.
No, we need some of the listeners. We're gonna start a GoFundMe.
We're gonna get y'all to donate.
The max is we're gonna try to reach $16 so we can get our coach some shoes.
Cross trackers.
Yeah, cross trackers.
Oh man.
Yeah, we'll start a GoFundMe page for him.
Payless. Yeah, you got to.
All right, Riz, back on you. What you got,
baby? Word up, big dog. Hey, we got, you know what I'm saying, we got a throwback, dog. We're going to just do a little quick movie deal, whatnot, man. New movie coming out, you know what I'm saying? Me, old heads like me and Cap, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. We grew up watching the Rambo series of movies.
Rambo, Sylvester. First Blood.
You know what I'm saying? First Blood.
The survival knife.
Bruh, that knife hit.
Everybody wanted that knife. They had the compass on it. Had a fishing line in it. Everything. Matchstick.
What?
Hey, but I couldn't find nothing, no reason to use none of that stuff when I went into the woods. In Morsel. There wasn't nothing, you know, nothing but grasshoppers and snails out there. You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God.
Hey, the survival knife.
Hey, man, that's a bad knife.
That was bad.
Rich, knife. Why are we talking about Rambo?
Good, man. Hey, look, man.
It's old school, man.
Tell him, man. Rambo is a classic. And he's coming out with the fifth.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? The fifth part five of the Rambo series. Now, remind you, now, Rambo got to be about 89 years old.
And that's why I'm not watching.
Playing it. That's why they're naming it the Last Blood.
Last Blood. Last Blood.
I mean, he might not make it through the whole Rambo.
He done been through some stuff now with
Rambo. Listen here, fellas.
Hey, yo,
yeah. What you got,
better off watching cartoon, man, than watching that, man.
I'm
not been to watch a 90-year-old man do an action movie. Come on, bro.
Why not?
I'm not watching Rambo, man.
Hey, man. Marshall, you just went and bought $16 Payless shoes, and you can't watch Rambo?
Nah, I'm not.
Hey, man,
I watch Rambo, but I'm not about to watch him while he's 90 years old. What I'm going to get out of that?
Hey, it's Stallone.
He's still a beast.
Oh, you like them young men. young actors.
Hey, y'all see what I'm dealing with. These cats still watching Rambo, man.
Hey, he got the sauce.
He do got the sauce.
He's seasoned.
It's all good. Most of y'all don't even know who Rambo is.
Remember hitting that damn mud, that little mud hill? Yeah, nothing but eyes.
Nothing but eyes.
They walked on by him.
That's it.
But that,
hey, but
that
you saw this?
Yep. Hey, I'm gonna watch it.
Y'all three should go and watch it together. I didn't buy y'all tickets, man.
We do a movie review. We do a movie review.
That's the thing. That was our entertainment back then. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like Rambo, everybody want to be like Rambo. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
that's back then.
But now everybody want to be rappers, knocking people out in malls and stuff,
man.
And leaving them with the pants down.
You know what I'm saying?
Sir, your belt.
Yeah,
it's like, come on,
sir, your belt.
Man. Yeah. And it's happening right in our backyard.
Right here in Charlotte. Where was it at? What mall?
South Park Mall.
What store was it? Louis store or something like that?
Louis store in South Park.
Oh, man.
Talking about DaBaby and Cam Cohart.
The baby.
Okay. The baby local rapper blew up right here in Charlotte, right straight.
Charlotte.
You know what I'm
Shout
saying?
Shout out to the baby.
Yeah, with no, you know, didn't have to go nowhere else to do it. Just did it right out this front porch.
Mm-hmm.
Blew up, you know, got them a little artist stunner for Vegas and Salisbury.
Okay, Salisbury.
And they're touring, doing shows. So you're gonna get some people that's gonna be hating on you a little bit. You know what I mean? I don't know how it actually started, but old Cam, he was on his Instagram, you know, talking about the baby doing this and that. Then if you're in a small town like Charlotte, you're going to run into each other. So Cam ran into the baby.
Oh, nice.
Hey, oh, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Wow. And he ran into the table when he was trying to back up.
He
ran into that table fell.
Scared of who? Scared of what?
Huh? Oh, Cam scared was scared.
Yeah, was scared.
I'm scared.
Then he swung in through the first. That, but how these boys, both of them, fighting with their phones in their hand?
Phone
recording.
In
the
hand.
Yeah, recording. I mean, I would at least hand it off. Hey, record, get this for me.
Yeah.
But they fighting like one hand, phone in
I'm
hand.
I'm going to beat you where they on one hand.
Yeah.
Huh.
So we had us a phone fight.
Generation.
Yeah, that's generation. One hand, phone in hand.
Yeah, okay.
So you're a fighter and a videographer. You know, same time. You know what I mean? Working on that Instagram. Next thing you know, like the whole post set up, Cam end up with his pants around his ankles.
Oh my God! Did he
draws out? You know, stunned and dazed, and then with the baby with the last word.
What the baby had to say?
Cam, huh? Cam, go on. I'm the truth. Knock him out. Me. Dolo. Now, and that's where the problem came in with Cam. He's like, oh man, you wasn't Dolo. You had your security guard, which turned out would be the baby's brother. He was like, you know, one big one, one little one. You know what I'm saying? So that's like saying, like, you know, if Marshall and Will in the mall and somebody trying to jump on Will, Marshall ain't gonna sit there and let it happen. You know what I mean? You're gonna be the big brother.
I might let Will get it.
Nah, man, you gotta help him.
I might let it go that day.
Hell
nah.
Hey.
Hey, stick and move, Will. Stick and move, baby.
But be a coach to him.
Coach him through it.
Let him do something, little Will. Come on, little Bob and little Will.
Hey, the truth be told, that's how you one on one. You know what I mean? That's like a good one on one.
That's how you learn.
Hey, but he got embarrassed on social media. But Cam, you know, he tried to come back. You know what I mean? Told him them boys were scratches. Said they was cat women.
Cat women. You can't come back after you get your behind whipped like that, man. Yeah. Come on now.
But, yeah, but
especially knocked out with your pants down.
Huh. Yeah, come on.
Tell me how is social media, when like his following went from like 15,000 to 60,000. After getting knocked out and his pants hanging out. You think this boy gonna get like a Louis sponsorship for belts?
He should. if he wanna market himself and make something out of it by getting your ass whooped.
Tell me making something good of a bad situation.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Hey, Cam Cohart, holler at the lecture hall. We got you. We'll be your street team.
Yeah. Street sweepers.
But I'm gonna tell you right now, you go up running your phone in somebody's face talking shit. Yeah. I'm gonna let you get your behind toe up.
No, we back him up, Rick. We do security. Let y'all security, man.
Yeah, we can't protect Porzingis from steel chairs and not help Cam Cohart.
And he right here in our backyard.
I guess so, man. I guess as long as he paying premium.
Yeah, definitely premium. Yeah, so we might have to have extra underwear on.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. We might have to pay somebody extra too. We might have to bring out a little wheel.
Hello, Cameron. Hey, I tell you what though. About them boys fight, you know, hey, I like that. You know, it was a good old fashioned fight.
Yeah.
Straight hands.
Oh yeah, yeah.
It wasn't like hands.
One hand.
Yeah, one
hand.
Straight hand.
Yeah, phone and
straight hand. Okay, it's great hand.
So it's like that that Michael Jackson video when they tied the hands together and it was
Instead of a knife, they had the phone in one hand.
Well, Mike will find his way, boy. He'll find his way, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Mike.
But you're right.
I like that, man. It wasn't no guns or anything.
It wasn't nobody trying to kill each other.
Or like afterwards, you're like, okay, y'all ain't getting me. But really, you got.
You took a L.
I'm with that too, Tig.
Because with this generation, man, it's all about guns and knives. Yeah, exactly. You know, because they scared to take a L because of the social media.
Exactly.
You know, but you all can see that even though getting your ass whooped, you still can get some kind of good from it. Because ain't his followers, his social media followers,
yeah, they went
jumped
up
through the roof.
They went up. His album sales went up too.
Yeah.
Dropped the album. You know what I mean? He getting some streams and sales. So
exactly.
I mean, getting your ass whooped ain't a bad thing.
It's a life lesson.
Yeah. It's a life lesson.
Knock him out.
Hey, the baby Dodo.
Me. What Willie said to Craig?
What'd he say?
You say you win some.
You win some.
You lose some.
But you live.
Remember that. You live.
You live to pick your pants up.
Yeah. Go on, buy a new belt.
Walk on out.
And it's
get
over.
Some new draws.
And it's over. And you ain't gonna win them.
So the baby made that. You see that T-shirt?
Oh man, I love that T-shirt.
But why they put a shit stain on Cam?
right in the middle of his draw.
Man, that's
funny. Hey, that was messed up. Hey, great.
Hey, sir, your belt.
But now that's marketing though with this social media stuff. So if you do something like that, do it for a reason. You know what I mean? Don't just go out there and do it and get locked up for it. But if you're going to do it for a reason. Market yourself.
But that's the thing. Don't let them go out there just taking L's for the hell of it.
That's the crazy part. They in South Park Mall, which is not a slum mall.
Yeah, that's like upscale.
Hey, that's rich.
And they tussling. And everybody just walk on out like
ain't nothing happened.
And at the Louis place, you have your officer right there at the door, chilling.
Well, not at a...
No,
you're right.
He said he saw him.
Sometimes he did.
They right there in the door.
Because the dude Cam went back to the store just to get confirmation that from the guard that at that point he's not happy with his L that he took.
Oh yeah.
So he's like telling the guard, like, didn't two dudes jump me, a big one and a little one? The guard like, yep, two. Two. And I would have been there, I'd been like, why the hell you ain't help me out? You know what I mean? Damn, it's just me.
Hey, Mr. Security Guard, I got knocked out. Can you please tell me what happened, Mr. Security Guard?
Man. The scratches.
Man, listen, I seen that video, boy. He been trying to get up. He been wobbling, man. Oh. He been trying, but I... Scratches ain't do that.
They bust him up good.
They bust him up good.
Yeah, he look at my face.
Huh. Look.
Scratches.
Yeah, he didn't show them knots in that head, though. And then he banged him upside his head. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. Cam, we got you, man. Lecture Hall Security. We'll be the A-team street sweepers. We got you, bro. Hire us. We right here in your backyard. So if you need help, need some extra clothes, need some extra underwear, we got you, bro. We here at Lecture Hall. Follow us on Instagram, Cam. We got you, bro.
Lakeshore Podcast.
Yes, sir.
So do you think, we're talking about the new age rappers, right? Yep. You know what I'm saying? They beef a little bit. But the baby, he been taking off, really been taking off, hitting the charts, Billboard charts with his new single, Shook. Mm-hmm. And I think last I looked, the album, Baby on Baby, hit peak number 7 on the Billboard charts for rap. Rap album. I mean, that's pretty big.
Oh yeah,
coming from Charlotte, doing that, and then the single itself is single digits. The single Shook. So, do you think from where he's at? Because I know, like, them boys making money. You know, back in the days, the artists they wasn't making a lot of money from just
not off doing sales.
Not off the sales. Exactly. You know, not off of just album sales, and but the touring, they're making money touring, and he's yet to like really pick up. You know. Product sponsorship is anything like that, but do you see this guy like he's making t-shirts now? So obviously he's a marketing, you know, he's got some marketing skills, he's got a good team behind him, but do you see him like reaching status like Jay-Z, being, you know, Jay-Z just reached, first rapper to reach billionaire, didn't he?
Yeah,
billionaire with a B,
and the baby just started his label, $1 billion Baby Entertainment. Do you think they're gonna get those billions?
Well, me personally, it got to be a lot more than just rap.
Yeah.
It got to be other things which we haven't seen yet. Like you said, he do got a good marketing team, and he doing things that he's supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
But we talking about, other things, investing. Like Jay-Z was a big part of a liquor.
You know,
and I think, if I'm not mistaken, he got like 400, it's like 440-something million just off liquor alone.
Yeah.
And then you got his rap.
100% of title.
Exactly. Then title like 100 million. He got 100 million in title.
Yeah.
You know, so when he start doing a lot of different things and these major companies start making major money, but Jay-Z, you know, the baby doing what Jay-Z did, he started in the music business.
Right.
No, I lied. He started off as a drug dealer.
Yeah, he was a hustler.
Let's be clear.
He
started off as a drug dealer, then got in the music industry, and not only that, he got 14 number one albums.
Yeah,
and that's a lot.
Exactly. That's pretty much every album he put out.
That's a lot. But he used that to other revenues, such as, like we said, liquor and title and a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
And today it came out where Jay-Z is the first rapper billionaire.
Yeah, in hip hop, first one. Hip-hop.
Yeah,
and it threw me for a loop because, you remember, like what I was talking before we started, I thought it was Dre. But Cap clarified it, man. Explain to the people, man. We all thought Dr. Dre was the first billionaire with that deal from Dr. Dre and Dre Beats.
Dre Beats
or whatever. But to explain and break that down, how he is not actually, his personal network is not actually
there. That's the thing. You know, Dre's name is on it. Beats by Dre, and Apple bought it for, it's a big multi-billion dollar purchase.
Bought it for like $3 billion.
Yeah, but his share was not worth that much because, you know, Dre's partnered up with someone. I can't remember who it was, but he's partnered up with someone, so everything's, you know, split and divided. Jay-Z just reached a billion status from with everything he got going
right.
on. And
show
Dre, Dre's up there. I mean, that put him up there from just the beats.
Just the beats,
Just beats alone. But, you know, if it would have been a deal just by himself, and if he owned 100%, that's what people like Nipsey, And that's the moves like Jay-Z be making. Yeah. Jay-Z own 100% of title.
100%.
And a lot of, you know, he's got some partnerships, but he's got businesses where he owns 100% of it. And that way you ain't got to worry about nobody getting a cut when they make that final move. You know what I'm saying? I think his first major deal was buying Rockefeller from Dame and getting him on out of there.
Yep.
And whether or not the label itself went up, that was his business move. To further, you know, Rock Nation.
Mm-hmm. I think Rockefeller, Rock Nation, that's like $75 million. But still, it's all
it's still,
in
it's
there.
A part of
that billion. being that status.
I think like 50, he's trying to, you know, he's trying to get there. He's got his hands in a lot of things, which about 50 funny as hell.
Oh, man.
He don't even know. Yeah. So somebody, I believe 50 gonna be the first old billionaire. You know what I mean? When he collect all his money,
his status gonna be.
And matter of fact, 50, if you ever get a hold of this episode, man, just show me where to send these $10, man. Cause I bootlegged one of your albums back in the day. Got it off Napster, and I'm gonna pay you back for you, damn. You know what I mean? For you, have me blasted out. You know what I'm saying? So
and that's another can of worms that we got to get to. You know, 50. And his tactics and all the stuff that he's do.
Yeah.
You gotta look at 50. When 50 do things, he's not doing it just to do it. It's a reason.
He's smart.
Cap probably already seen it. You know, now you're saying a lot of people owing 50 money.
Yeah.
So I think that somebody stepped in and said, "Hey, 50, we about to make you a debit card. A credit card. Now he about to get paid just off
that. Yeah, he about to get broke off.
Just by the tactics that he been doing. But we're going to get back on Jay-Z. That's another can of worms.
Word up.
You know, about his billionaire status. And if the baby can follow that blueprint, ain't no doubt in my mind that one day he may can reach that status.
Yeah, you just got to invest. You got to go in different avenues, you know what I'm saying? Because you, like Cap said earlier, you ain't gonna make that billion doing music alone.
Yeah,
exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Not gonna happen.
So make your money, make more money.
And that's the entry. And I wouldn't suggest going the route that a lot of people that don't realize. Just so your listeners know, that the guys, you know, it ain't like their career choice was to sell drugs, you know, in the streets. It's what in their environment.
Yeah.
It's just what they was dealt with in society. And that's why, you know, we always talk about doing different things in community and trying to show. That's why, you know, one of the big purposes about the lecture hall to get to know us and know that there's different avenues to, you know, to get that start. And we're always talking about different business ventures and this and that. So that's not the last or only resort in the hood. And as y'all can see, like there's a lot complicated now because people, you know, I'm hearing a lot of people just getting messed up over it. You know what I'm saying? Real bad.
Show you.
So you're not only, you know, trying to get into business. You know what I'm saying? But you're ruining lives.
Yeah.
And you know, the community just got to realize that. So there's different avenues to get that start. And like I said, once you get that, you know, you get in, you save that loot up, jump on, you know, start something. Like back in the day, we'd get one lawnmower and start cutting yards, $10 a piece, you know what I'm saying? And just racking up, saving up.
And she went, hey, but where that crowbar.
I think old buddy was from Lowers.
Your country. Definitely from the south.
He definitely look like some
Lowers. That Tig homeboy. But speaking of what I'm saying, and investing and all this, man, who y'all think some of the most wealthiest hip hop artists are besides Hov?
Yeah, we talked about Hov. Next, got to be Diddy.
Definitely got to put Diddy. We talked about Dre.
I think those 1, 2, and 3 right there.
Yeah.
On the top 25 list. Yeah, you got Hov
1, Diddy 2.
See, I don't think 50 is gonna be that high on the list. But I think, you know, he's gonna be in a million, but these boys like hundreds.
You got Dre at third at 820.
Mm. Yeah. Awesome headphones.
Tell them, Tig.
Russ still in the game, man.
Russ and Down Dog, you know what I mean? Counting his money.
In the Down Dog, Yoga. Russ Pilates.
Yeah, Russ is a yoga guru.
He
man.
Be on that, oh, Zen, that Zen Master
Zen
stuff.
Master.
That deep cleanse.
Namaste.
Then who we got at 5, man?
Okay. Kanye.
Yeezy. How much did they order?
$250 million.
Man,
all on shoes, though. All on
he make a lot of. But hey, Ye, Ye is a hell of a producer, though.
He's a hell of a producer.
He's
done a lot of work. That's what got him in.
I'm about to say, part of it because he struggled to get in. No one really gave him a chance.
That song right there.
Yeah.
That song right there.
And Jesus Walk.
Yep. Because that was his demo. Jesus Walk was his demo song.
But no one took that song seriously.
No, not at all. Until he actually put it out there.
And everybody blew up. And everybody had to go through something. And Kanye went through that bad accident, man. And he came out with that video song, The Y, and had a video. Man, that was one of the most motivational things I've ever seen in my life, especially coming from a rapper.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, so that made me a Kanye fan right there, man. So you got to be smart. You got to be smart with your marketing. He used that accident.
Yeah.
For something positive.
Because he was already talented. Yeah.
Just like being shot.
Yep. Just like Cam Cohort used that accident.
he had two accidents.
Right? Yeah. So he used that to make the best out of it.
Yo, yeah, we got, hey, number six, yo.
P. Miller.
Ooh.
Straight out the trunk.
Now, hey, a lot of these young cats might not know about Master P, man, but P. Yeah. P on everything from the doggone actual CD to the masters to the copyright to what else, Cap? The publishing and he owns every single part of it.
He was one of the first. Yeah, he was one of the first at with the record. You know, with the record deals, like owning like his masters and
No Limit Records.
Yeah. And remember when he came out with the cell phone?
I got the wireless. Yeah. I got the hook.
And had the movie to go with it.
If you hear me. But he was ahead of his time, man. He did that.
Yeah. He had a golden platinum tank.
Yeah, he did.
That joke was tough,
man.
That was tough.
But it was everywhere. He was like, he had ads in every magazine.
Everything, yo.
Hold on. Did y'all have the CD, though?
The one that had the hologram on it, that was tough. All of them No Limit CD covers were dope, man. They all had diamonds and gold and a tank.
Fellas, at that time, I couldn't afford that CD y'all bought.
And you had them, what you mean,
we had that burnt CD.
Yeah, that was before, you might have been. Yeah, I don't think they were.
Yeah, I'm about to say you. But you were probably what, middle school when P was pumping. No, it might not even be middle school.
Elementary.
Yeah.
Elementary, DMX and all that was a little.
Oh, DMX. Yeah, P was before X.
Well, exactly. Yeah, but I still remember like sixth grade, like fifth, sixth grade, all that stuff was pumping, man. You know, videos, Trick Daddy and all that stuff.
Oh, yeah. T-Dumb on the microphone.
like me.
All right.
You don't know that. It represents AB. AB. Oh boy! Hey, here we go, man. Hey, number seven, Eminem.
That's good.
That is.
Break from 8 Mile.
Damn, man, I see Dre, all them boys on the Interscope.
Yep,
Interscope, exactly. Right?
Interscope. Let's see. Hey, this one right here, though.
Usher, Let It Burn, huh?
Boy, stop. You ain't right.
Confession. That is
a hell of a
yeah. That was good.
That was a hell of an album.
It's great, man.
Confession. Yeah. Oh. Slim Williams. Now, Amash, I'm gonna let you handle it. I know you ain't a big Slim guy, but let people know who Slim actually is.
I guess Slim.
Yeah, I don't know.
I guess Slim is like the president of Cash Money Records. Mm-hmm. When it first came out, he was a guy like behind the scene. You ain't seeing much, you know. During that time, you see like Juvie and Lil Wayne and Baby, but Slim was like the president. He was behind the scenes, who was orchestrating everything. And you can best believe his money is real long.
Yeah.
Long.
Yeah,
what number he at, Rich?
He at Slim at nine. At 170 million. Yeah. Personal.
Yeah.
That ain't him and Baby. That's him.
That's him, yo. All right.
And then 10.
Okay, I like that.
Talk to him then,
Ted.
But I feel like he should be up a little bit higher.
Ooh. I agree.
Ice Cube.
Who?
I agree.
Ice Cube.
Yeah.
Just because, Cube. You know, just because, like,
say it was
like
a good day.
Yeah, exactly, man. Cube did a lot.
Ice Cube, yeah, that's
no bargain from the dog, no smoke. Okay. And mama's cooking breakfast with no hog. Was that Q telling us he was gonna be like he's working on his Muslim religion?
Something, man, it sound like to me.
Yeah, mama didn't have no hog in the breakfast.
Yeah, it sound like to me.
I like bacon.
That mean he was
breakfast.
Eating egg whites and you know
he was healthy.
Yeah, he was eating healthy.
Healthy.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Just, yeah. Like, just like earlier, me, we were talking about old Pops earlier.
Yeah,
yeah. He created that.
Yeah,
Who left? Oh, number left.
Louisy F.
F, baby.
Oh, Pharrell at 12.
Pharrell, yeah.
Okay. Pharrell at 12.
The guy that don't age out here.
Because bro. I'm happy.
Yeah, yeah, he a vampire, man. Yeah. Yeah, he a vampire.
How old is Pharrell?
For real,
Snoop.
Woo. Snoop Dogg.
Hey, oh, Snoop, how much Snoop worth?
130. I think okay, it's 130. Snoop. Hey, now this is my guy,
Snoopy.
135. Yeah. Well, I ride with Snoop.
But that's what I'm saying. Oh, yeah. Snoop. Look, think about it. Like Snoop worth more than 50. Like 50 doing a lot. That's what I'm saying. Like 50 doing a lot. Even got, you know, like I said, power. You know what I mean? You got other shows,
the boxing, the vodka, the liquor, movies. Actually, got another movie coming out as well with Rambo
and all the people that owe him money. But oh, Snoop, yeah. Snoop, you know, he did some network stuff.
Oh yeah,
but Snoop may be one of the ones that's like really making a lot from his music.
Yeah,
like and people over still time, over yo. Time, over like time. Over the time frame.
And like a thing is like. Everyone listened to Snoop.
Everybody.
I mean, it didn't matter who you were, white, black,
right.
Mexican, Asian.
That West Coast, you know, big.
It didn't matter.
He said, yo,
big market out there on the West.
Snoop has sold 23 million albums in the U.S. alone and over 35 million worldwide, man. Yeah. And they love, like y'all said, they love that dude everywhere.
I'm
And I think he'd have a little more if he didn't smoke all that them trees.
Well, hey, do you think Snoop
he
invested?
Oh yeah.
Oh, so
yeah.
I know it.
Of course he did.
2020.
Well, why not? Uh oh, nigga, your boy. Old Drake.
Oh, Drizzy at 14. Old Drake himself.
Drake.
We gonna go on past him. We ain't gonna talk too much here. Oh, LL.
LL made the top 15.
LL. Ladies love. All right, man. We got to hurry up, man. It's almost half time.
Who is that?
Yeah, right.
Adam.
Adam Horowitz.
Known as Ad Rocker King. Ad Rocker. He's an American musician. Guitar. Oh, Beastie Boys. He's a member of the Beastie Boys.
Okay. Next.
Mike D.
Oh, man.
Mike D.
So
all the Beastie Boys
All the Beastie Boys. I bet you they... Nikki.
Okay, Nikki. Okay, Nikki. Representing the females. I can dig that.
Nikki. Timbo.
Timbaland.
19.
Yeah, Timbaland did a lot, man, producing this.
Okay, stuff. Akon, yeah.
Akon and Young Jeezy. Trying to take it easy.
Oh, Birdman. Like, hey, Ricky Ross said, man, Birdman will be letting his people eat.
Hey, what was Birdman known for the interview he had? And when he came in on the
all tree, y'all. Yeah, I said that earlier.
Is y'all done?
Put some respect on my neck.
Done? Either you done or you ain't.
Pitbull
is
on
the Pitbull or is you finished?
Pitbull 22. Will I am. Okay. Rev Run. Shout out Rev Run. Okay. Who number 25 on this thing? Nas.
Can't believe I let Nas down.
Nas. Hey, Nas investing in that alcohol as well.
That's the top 25.
Yeah, there it is.
No 50.
But you can't believe his money is more longer than a lot of those cats on that list. But he don't put his stuff out there like that, though.
Nope. Don't let him lie to you.
Oh, yeah, man.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, there's a whole lot of money in the first half of this game.
A whole lot of money. Hey, we like talking money on the lecture hall too.
We like talking investments.
We like talking entrepreneurship.
Yes.
But guess what? It's halftime. Halftime. We're gonna get on out of here. We're gonna get out of here. Next half, we're gonna introduce Marshall's right foot.
Yes, sir.
Oh yeah.
The left foot is the chalice.
Yeah.
All right, we out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, boy.
You ain't home, is you? You ain't count down yet.
Oh, Lord, Jesse made another one.
Huh.
You don't love me, don't tell me you love me. Cause I can go fuck on your friend.
Yeah.
I can hook up with your buddy.
Yeah.
I ain't got time to pretend.
Yeah.
I'm trying to give me some cutty.
Yeah.
And I ain't really trying to be friends.
Yeah.
I'd rather get to the money.
Money.
I try to talk to the my dream is she looked at
okay.
me funny. Everything I done dreamed, I done done.
Okay.
That's how they do it, that guy. Now I done this time with some make up something, go with it.
Yeah.
Make up something, go with it.
Look at the dance.
Yeah. I'm fronting bags to my homies. I'm still in the
streets.
She don't really love me. We play up and count up the back
end. They say Cap be solo. I'ma knock him out dolo. I'ma put him down on his YOLO. Let's get going. Let's do this.
Back from halftime.
This is, hey, that's a motivational speech right there.
Yeah.
Shout out to right the baby.
The baby. The baby.
The baby with the motivational speech at halftime, man.
Come on.
Put us in a good mood.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Put us in a good mood.
Hey, Tig, are we up or are we down?
Hey, we up, right now, man.
We up right now. We up. Just say we up.
Hey, first of all, we talked about all this money going around.
Man, it's out here to get.
It's
out here to get.
But
it's a whole lot of money out
there. I did lose a little bit this past weekend from Tesla, man. Tesla messing up, man.
Man, you better talk to him.
I ain't got no Tesla stuff.
Come on, Elon.
Talk to him.
Well, Cap, you know what you're doing then.
Talk to him, Odie.
I need to
talk to him. Come on, Odie.
It's all good though. You know, hey, they'll come back up.
Yeah,
especially now where they got cars driving
bounce them, back
themselves.
Man, listen, I ain't getting one of them.
No Tesla. Right.
I ain't getting. Y'all ain't never watched iRobot. Will Smith tried to tell y'all back in the day, don't be messing with that stuff. And y'all got them automatic vacuum cleaners and shit.
Hey,
at the house.
I seen an automatic lawnmower.
Yeah,
I seen an automatic lawnmower.
No, you gonna
start it with a crowbar?
You gonna come home one day and you ain't gonna have no control or nothing.
Yeah. I think crowbar for.
I tell you. Stop
my lawnmower.
You gonna mow the yard? You gonna mow the dog?
Oh,
everything.
Man.
Everything.
E.
Come on, Marshall. All right.
Welcome back to halftime, second half of episode 14 of the Lecture Hall, y'all.
Y'all.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Y'all. And we are here with Marshall Payless McFadden.
Payless.
Hey, today we're about to get into
sports.
Sports.
Yes.
Well, we're going to start off something simple.
Anchorman McFadden.
Wow, we're gonna start with something. We're gonna talk about these playoff finals, man, with the Golden State Warriors and Toronto Raptors. Just right. Tying even the series 1-1. Golden State won last night, and the series is even. And I just want to get y'all take on what y'all boys thinking, especially going forward. What you gonna take on it, Rich, Tig?
Hey, man, I don't got no dog in the fight, but I like Kawhi. The laugh is out they bought it.
Let me hear the laugh one time.
Kawhi, you like Kawhi? Tell her Kawhi. Tell her why you like Kawhi.
Why we like
his laugh?
Kawhi. Well, because of the laugh. And
is it like a woodpecker?
It's deep. Like it's almost it's like a deep woodpecker.
Stupid, man.
Hey, if you make it big like Kawhi, like how would you laugh? You got to work in your laugh like your signature.
You just gotta, I got mine.
It won't be that.
It won't be.
It won't be that.
They be like, "Hey, Rich, did you have a good game?"
Yeah. That's it. Yeah. Show you right.
Show you right.
I'm a trademark.
Man.
Get them boys, hey, man. They owe me, dog.
Hey, might as well, man.
Golly,
might
as well. Man. But now, Kawhi balling. Hey, Kawhi is this, what? He averaging, about 30. He dropped 30 last game?
Yeah.
31,
yeah.
Something like that.
34 and 14. Rebounds.
Well, see,
34 and 14, dog.
See, I'm a Hornets fan, right? And, you know, I like to see these boys, you know, these boys play because we ain't been. You know, in the finals in ever.
Mm-hmm.
And
show you right.
You know, so I'm looking at the Warriors play and everybody's, you know, used to talk about how they got these, you know, these weapons and this and that, like, you know, well, just Kate, you know, KD doing this, or KD hurt and doing that, you know, Steph when he off or whatnot. So they've been doing what they're doing without KD.
Mm-hmm.
And they got some other players, you know, that's hurt.
You know, the Splash Brothers split up, and people coming out the bench, the players are coming out the bench just draining and filling in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Marcus Cousins come in, you know, doing a whole lot.
And like I say, even he technically hurt. I mean, he pulled his hamstring game one.
Yeah.
Mm. Then came back game two and did hell of a job.
Yeah.
No, that's good. Who you talking about, Iguodala or
No, he talking about Boogie.
Clarify Tig's situation. He had tore his quad early in the season.
Oh yeah,
and he just getting back. That's why when he played the first game,
he only
played a couple minutes. But Iguodala, did you know strain his calf or whatever? Then he came back and played game two.
Hey, if we all got the same amount of money, is that Iguodala's too?
If you want to put it that way,
I want y'all money, so I want equal dollars.
I rolled that.
Equal dollars. I like that. But he hit an important shot. You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
He wasn't doing a lot the whole game, but he had a very important shot to end the game to seal it all.
Yeah, and that's the thing with the Warriors, and Cap kind of hit on it, that you got guys coming off the bench and stuff. Warriors, man, not only are they a shooting team because they got a lot of guys that can shoot them, but they're a smart IQ team. And you can take a average team that got good IQ, and they can go and beat a lot of good teams,
right?
You know,
right.
With a lot of ability. So that's the thing I respect about the Warriors, their IQ, their ability to get open, shoot, and their ability to win without their star players. Because actually, we all know Kevin Durant is down.
Yep.
Klay Thompson went down. Even though he did play about 30 minutes last night, but he still went down with a hamstring injury that he having an MRI, and we don't know if he's going to be able to play Wednesday. But that's the luxury of having a good ball club, you know, because, you know, on some of these teams, if, you know, so Anthony Davis go down or another star player, then they –
Like LeBron,
if Kawhi go down,
if LeBron go down, then it's done, over with.
Bye bye. And speaking on LeBron, man, when he went down in the season, you know, they was at the top of in the Western Conference.
They was not at the top.
Yes, they were. There was one game out of first place in the Western Conference. That's not the top. He's talking about racing.
You were like front row. Is on the front row.
Okay, guys.
So you got one and two. You both on the front row.
But to my point, when he got injured and when he came back, they was at the bottom of the West.
Well, he wasn't playing good when he came back.
Yes, he was. That's a big difference.
You know, he was not.
What you mean?
Hey.
What did he average, Rich? Pull up what LeBron averaged this year.
Pull up his average.
No, this year we will not talk about the Lakers because they are not in the championship.
Pull up his average. Draymond, sleeper. Double double. He almost had a triple double. But he's doing it quietly.
Draymond's a big part of that ball club.
Yes, he is.
Say that's a sleeper. He's a big part of the ball club. He's putting up
almost triple double.
He put up a triple double.
He had that in and out game. Double double, man.
He put up a triple double last week. But that's what he do. He'll get you about 10 points. He'll get you about maybe 10 assists, and may get you a couple rebounds. That's Draymond.
That's good.
But he's the spearhead of that group. He control all of that. He's like the big point guard. When somebody out like KD or Cousin, Draymond pick up the slack.
Right.
But when all of them there, he kind of relax a little bit. And they came out and said, when you got a guy like KD, you can relax a little bit because you know he can go and get buckets.
Wasn't Draymond who was blowing in LeBron ear? No, that was Steven, crazy Lance.
Hey, boy, now you want to talk about getting some likes and followers. That man got some followers off of
blowing it in. Yeah. Hey, I'm pretty sure all of them wasn't good followers, but he was followers.
And then at the end of his career, guess who he had to come play with? LeBron.
Man, the same guy that's sitting at home right now.
Yeah.
But now, we're going to get back on this NBA Finals, though. But believe it or not, this is going to be a great series. I think it's going to Game 7. I get it edged to Toronto.
I do, too. I like Toronto.
Hey, I'm giving Golden State.
Cool.
Yeah, that's fine.
Everybody's tired of their own opinion. He's biased. He was just talking about Dame Leonard was the
Drake
player.
The Drake curse, man. You can't beat the – you can't – Yep. You can't defy the Drake curse.
Drake, better – man, stop putting on these jerseys now.
Yep.
You put on the jersey, boy, be taking L's, man.
I like what Drake did, though. You know, just for a little tactic, he put on Dale Curry jersey when he used to play with Toronto. That was pretty dope. I like that. And he pulling Lin out Curry hair when he walking on the sideline.
Nah, that's a bit much.
Yeah. That's a bit much.
It's a bit much.
You paid for them seats down there, man. Drake the ambassador, bro.
No, NBA mad at Drake though.
He didn't ambassador.
He's doing too much down there. NBA mad at him. They gonna kick him out.
He like Diddy.
He worse than Spike Lee.
No, he like Diddy in 90 back in 93, 94, 95.
Drake don't even make movies.
All in the video.
That's all about Mark.
Exactly.
It's all in the background.
Hey, y'all think is Peter a Toronto fan?
Oh yeah, he probably. I'm sure.
Gotta be. It's only team up there. We the North. He won't tell us.
But I'm sure when that game start, Pete at the crib, cutting the TV on, probably drinking some hot latte or something like that.
Kombucha.
Yeah, a kombucha.
Kombucha.
I'm sure. Just eating it all up, man.
Let's go Toronto. Yeah. Let's go. We are the North.
Son Pete from the North.
Shout out Pete and Lil Will, man. Shout out Pete.
But I think it's gonna be a good series. Like I said, I think going to Game 7. I think Toronto will win. I like their team. They got a good team, a scrappy team, and they got guys that can come off the bench and score the basketball as well. Not only that, I think they probably had the best defense in the playoff. They are a great defensive team. And I never seen anybody play the Warriors with the defensive style. I seen last night where for three minutes straight, the Warriors ain't even get a bucket. Mm-hmm. Not one bucket. Mm. Now you talking about defense. That's some good stuff, and I think that's gonna make this a good series. And I think that's why I can go to Game 7.
Hey, and
I was going to 6.
I think they should run a Chick-fil-A offense. You know what I mean?
Oh, you gotta explain that to me, guys.
You never wait for that long for a score. You know, if you run a Chick-fil-A offense,
there you go. That makes sense.
Yeah, they always got it moving.
That's true. That is true though.
They got two lines.
Two lines. Yeah.
Pumping.
Now, Marshall, how the series games goes? Because is it 2, 3, and 2?
Well, I think now that it's the finals is every so 3 days they'll play.
No. I'm talking about home, away, and home. So
well, home, it was home, two, away.
It's 3 in the middle and then back home for the last two, right?
Well, it depends if you still if well, you
yeah
still,
if you still going if you still, yeah yeah, yeah.
It,
still
so
going.
It depends on if you still in game or not the way it's
but it's 1-1 so they got to go to a 6
yeah
so
yeah.
So they gonna end up
and
in
if
Toronto,
in Toronto
at least.
If you go to 7 they end up in Toronto
All right that's what it is man. Hey we the North man go T dot
Holla. Go Toronto
Holla.
Sorry. Let's go Warriors.
I paid taxes up there at one point
man
time.
them high taxes too man
go T dot yeah
I don't think hold on it don't. It's 1-1. If they Warriors win 3 more, that's it.
Oh, they could win it at home. They could win it at home
that's
on the 3rd.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. Depending on who wins, the win or lose, the way you're going
to
play it.
But I think they're going to have to go back to Toronto.
I get Warriors in 6.
Toronto.
Warriors in 6.
Tig, you just said you like the Bobcats.
Exactly. I'm telling you, last week, you like the Bobcats. Hey. And I don't even think they'll touch no more.
It's the big starter.
It's the big starter.
Beat you to it.
And I get Warriors in 6.
Shut up, Chuck. Hey, I don't want to hear it, Chuck.
Hey, yeah, let's hear it one time, T. Let me see.
Hey, I just did it.
I was in my thought.
You got to leave them thoughts alone.
They get you in trouble.
Thoughts.
Mess around with them thoughts.
Let's clarify that. You know.
Why?
Okay, Riri. Do you think, whoop?
Ass I beat sometime, man.
Sometimes
you get a feeling, Rick.
Yeah, tell him. Tell it, Odie.
Sometimes you get a feeling. Sometimes you have an out of body experience.
Yes. Now, how do you end up out of your body, though?
Talk about a TKO.
How you end up out of your body? Somebody tell him.
I'm talking about Anthony Joshua, man.
Man.
What happened to Anthony Joshua?
Hey, you know, sometimes you get a feeling. Sometimes you get the feeling knocked out of you.
Yeah.
But
when you got a guy look like Butterbean come in,
exactly,
you're sleeping,
hit you with them haymakers.
Oh man,
at this mind, your dad going old school boxing.
Andy Ruiz,
and it didn't matter.
Andy Ruiz Jr.
Oh, Medicon. What happened? What happened?
No, though? You tell it.
Yeah. What you mean? They brought it up. Why you want me to tell it? What you talking about?
You're a sportsman, McFadden.
What happened?
Cross trainer.
Oh man.
I didn't watch the fight.
Go ahead. I ain't watch it either, but I
saw
up,
50
but
posts.
I looked it up.
All I saw was that man Soul walking out.
Going to the airplane.
About, you talk about it.
I'm gonna find a clip and I'm gonna play it. I'm gonna play it in the episode.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta put it up there, man.
Yeah, because you can't explain it when the out of body experience. There's no way to explain it.
It's no way to explain it.
Whoever whipped that video up there, hell of a job.
So yeah, Andy Ruiz.
Who?
You know, Andy Ruiz Jr.
Big upset.
Yeah.
So Anthony Joshua, talk about Anthony Joshua. You know, was this a title fight?
Yeah.
It was, right? Heavyweight? Yeah. Heavyweight bout?
Yeah, it was title fight. Heavyweight WBA bout. Or something like that.
Man, whoever bet money on Ruiz.
Man, oh yeah.
You know they made a killing.
They lying big.
I should have bet money on Ruiz.
Hmm. Anytime you see a center come in the ring and fighting against a guy that's 6'6", you know, undefeated.
Oh, man.
You know, look like he been carved out of a book. Of course.
Hey, he was swinging.
And like when I see, and like so like before the race or whatnot, I saw the bottom. I'm like, you know, this guy is the champ. You know, talking about Josh. Joshua,
yeah.
And then I was like, dang. But Andy Ruiz, like, he looked like he could actually take a punch.
Oh, yeah. He's a big old boy now.
But at the same time, it don't look like he going to go 9 rounds.
No.
Yeah.
So I was like, man, it should be a good one. But then.
But if you look at that fight and see him fighting, and to your point, T, he was a pretty good, impressive fighter, though.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
He can move. He can swing. He can hit. And he just knew how to. Even though he got knocked down twice. But he still got back up and, you know, went to war. And there's another situation. It's another situation. Oh, God. Come on, y'all. Hey, y'all boys. Y'all taking my shine, man.
I'm up. I'm on it. My thing is, because you said you didn't know. We didn't watch it. They're like, I'm hearing a lot of good details about what happened to the fight.
Listen to what I said, I was like, I read up on it, though.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
So when you go back and listen.
I didn't know Ruiz got knocked down twice.
I guess you was in your thoughts, too, huh?
Yeah. I didn't know he got knocked down twice.
Yeah, he got knocked down twice. Oh, but what I want to say is, man, don't judge a book by its cover. You'd be surprised, because Joshua went in there, he was posing with Drake. I'm about to break the curse, I'm about to do this and do that.
That was a Drake curse.
And he ended up getting knocked out in the 7th round.
No,
you know, so
no, tell him what really happened.
And to my point, I don't think Joshua took it serious. So when it come to training, preparing for the fight,
yeah,
I feel on that more.
Eating, training, and doing that, I don't think he took it serious. And that guy, Ruiz or Andy or whatever you want to call him, that guy was prepared for it. Like he was training his ass off. And then when he got his moment, he knocked his ass out in the seventh round. So big up to that guy. I'm always rooting for the underdog. I'm an underdog myself. So a guy like that can come in and knock somebody out like that. Man, Pluto's to you, bro.
Pluto's, baby.
Yeah, yeah.
Pluto's, baby.
Yeah.
So that should be inspiration for Cam Cohort. If he goes 7 rounds with the baby. After getting knocked out of his britches twice, you know what I mean? He can maybe come back.
He ain't coming back from that. He ain't coming back.
Man, I'm trying to, man. I'm trying to get him back in there. I'm trying to get him with a W, man.
They say Anthony Joshua, he came in with 3 major world titles.
Yeah, he's big dog. He's big dog.
He's the truth.
Not no more.
Dolo.
Big dog.
No, he's the truth.
Quit playing me, boy.
Hey, Cap. You just make sure you put up that video.
Oh, the out of body. All right,
cause, man, 50 put up.
Yeah, 50
put
funny,
up
man.
A video where Anthony Johnson got hit
in
by
back
Ruiz
in
and
then
boom.
Anthony Johnson.
He went like this.
And then his soul
walked out.
Left the ring. Got on the escalator with his luggage. Got on the plane.
It's a hologram now. The hologram just left.
Yeah, just left
the airport.
Went back home. Flew back home.
And left Buddy in the ring.
Him in the ring.
Man, I'm going to tell you, I know a lot of people that would have done the same thing. They soul would have left him too, man. Gone. Get popped in the back of the head like that.
Bro, that was funny. That was funny.
Yeah, that was funny.
And where you going, bro?
Where he going? He's going to crank up the lawnmower. Cut the yard.
But yeah, so when you're going into battle, you better prepare because you don't want to judge that book by its cover because you don't know what that person doing on the other end.
Right.
And a prime example of what happened to Anthony Joshua. So, hey, next time you fight, bro, take it serious.
Take it serious.
Or the same thing going to happen again, bro. You can believe that. Put you and Cam Cohart in the same situation. Uh-huh. Hey, you know what we should do?
What's
that? Put them boys in the ring.
Who? Anthony Joshua
and Cam. Old Cam.
We no, that wouldn't that be up. Fair.
No, ain't
no, no,
he no, that's a fighter.
That'd be L number two.
Because you got two. You got two people. Anthony Joshua. You said what kind of titles he got? Rich. You said he had three.
Yeah, they said three, but they didn't say exactly which three.
Three major titles.
Yeah. So Anthony Joshua's got three belts, and Cam's got one belt, like a Louis belt.
And he lost that.
Yeah, and he lost that.
Lost.
So he already lost his belt. So it'd be an exhibition match.
But because he don't mind getting knocked out and beat up and any
same way. They scratches though, man. All them scratches. That's what Andy said. He said Ruiz Jr. is a scratcher, man. Yeah, a scratcher, man. Ain't hurt
that's
him.
Why he didn't take his shit.
Catwoman's.
He scratched the back of his head. I see that.
That's got to be embarrassing, man. Be at the top of the top and, you know, you get knocked out by a center. You know, guy 6'2". About 300 pounds. You think he can't barely move. You think
that's
he can't
thing
go, and you think he can't do that.
He was built like a deacon at church.
She with a lot of fabric on his suit.
Sitting up there huffing and puffing.
Yeah.
She with a lot of fabric on his suit.
Oh, yeah.
Boy, hey, T, that video you showed me, bro.
No, hey, just
watch it. The big guy. Well, we were watching TV.
Yeah. Hey, that dude literally had on a bedspread.
Oh, man.
Two of them. Two of them. Hey.
Lead that man.
That was
alone.
A lot of fabric, bro. I don't know who made that suit, but hey, they did a hell of a job.
Damn.
That was a lot of fabric.
Mm-mm-mm.
Oh, man.
So, but, man, go ahead.
Hey, I was about to say, I was about to hand it back to Marshall Mack, man.
Nah, you got it.
No, but that's your boy at the bottom now. You got on his shoes today.
Oh, I got Lou Zion.
You going to do a pissed out you want to.
Yeah, I get right.
You got to bring him up, man.
Yeah, get the right one.
I got the right shoe.
Since
we about to talk about Zion.
Hey, but them things, they going ceramic coated and everything. Got a little ceramic coat on.
There it is.
Boom. Boom.
That's nice there, Cap.
Boom. Like hey, hit the strap again. Hey, this mic. Let him hit.
And this is all you can do if you want to. Yeah. You call this a universe.
Hey, that scrap do sound a little weak today, though. yesterday, it sounded a little bit stronger.
Yeah.
Hey, man, the scrap wearing out.
It's going to sound like.
The scrap wearing out.
It's going to sound like scotch tape tomorrow.
It's going to be sticking up.
Yeah.
It's going to be sticking up.
Yeah, curl, you going to be curling up.
It's going to be doing this.
Hey, DeMar.
Curling
up.
Hey, everybody stay down.
Hey, every time y'all see DeMar, y'all see me bending over.
Hey, Marshall got to do them like pitch you, put some tape around them.
Exactly.
Oh, man. I love these shoes, man.
Payless?
Good.
Payless?
Payless.
Now, what you saying about Zion? Now, what he do? Bro?
Yeah, what Zion do?
Well, he didn't really do much, but they're speculating or talking to him about Zion Williams could play for the Team USA this summer. And that would be big time for a guy that ain't even step on the NBA court yet to actually play for Team USA. Team USA.
That has happened before, though, with the Christian Leighton in the Dream Team.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Christian Lake was the only college player because they usually take one college player
for
the national team, man. And I remember that.
But they usually ride in of the bit.
Oh, yeah. He way down there. Because when Dream Team, when they had that documentary on Dream Team, and them boys had an inner squad right
on. And they just had to pick. They ain't got nothing to do with you.
Yeah. So he sat behind on the sideline.
Yeah.
He did nothing.
And watched them boy go to work.
You know who went off, though? My boy Mike.
MJ?
Hey, Mike.
I think that's
Mike and Magic. They were going at him. Hey, Mike said, hey. He said, give me Scotty, Patrick, Charles, and Mullins. You can have everybody else.
But I think that's when Magic and Larry know that, okay.
Yeah, they had to hand the pass over.
Yeah, you got to pass
because they was what, about 8-7 years older than MJ?
Yeah, yeah. So that's when they actually passed the torch to hey, man, this guy here is
a yeah.
But Zion planned it. Mm-hmm. If Zion could play this summer, you're talking about boosting the rating sky high.
Of course.
And you're talking about a guy that actually going to play. I might even start.
No, I don't know all that.
Hey, listen, bro. Listen here, man. So he gonna
take LeBron, please.
LeBron ain't playing in that no more. It's over with for LeBron. He not.
You right? You said. Hold on. Say that again. Say that again.
That's a young man.
No.
Say
it
again.
Come on, it's what for LeBron?
Yeah.
It's what for LeBron?
He not playing. No, that's below him, man.
You said it's over.
LeBron just getting started.
That's below him, bro.
No, you said it's over for LeBron.
Yeah, in the USA. Literally, it's over. Yo, he's gonna be on the boat this summer, chilling.
He ain't coming back.
Mm-hmm. He gonna be on the boat somewhere hanging out this summer, man. He ain't doing all of that. That's a young man game.
So he done with basketball, huh?
That would sound like to me.
That would sound like, what is that what he say? Like,
oh, you ain't playing, is you?
No, he ain't playing no more. He done went to Hollywood and ain't ended with tired.
Oh, he went commercial.
Brand new.
Went to LA and changed
and
him.
Changed him.
Hey, LeBron, you doing something right, boy. Every week, the boy talk about
he
you,
ain't
man.
Claiming
keep
Ohio
doing,
no
you keep
more.
Doing what you do, man.
So, more pretty much, he gonna have fresh legs next season.
Fresh legs.
Yeah. But he averaged 30. He averaged 30 next year.
But he gonna get hurt again.
So, he didn't. He averaged what, 27?
He did ball. 28,
I think.
But he can't play
though. That was pretty good.
He can't keep playing the minutes like how he been playing though. Because
he played the most minutes in the NBA. Yeah. You're talking about a 32, 33-year-old. You know, so that's pretty good, man. That goes to show you what he's doing in his offseason. He ain't got time. He got to train to get right for the season.
That man making movies and stuff. What are you talking about offseason? He ain't shooting no basketball. No, he ain't. He got a school to run.
LeBron James.
He's a part owner of a Premier League soccer team. What a older that man got a production company. He coaching his son AAU team from the sideline.
Show you right.
Got his own show.
Yep. In the barbershop.
Hey,
LeBron, let us get them chairs for the lecture hall. Let's get them chairs. What else he doing?
He doing a lot of stuff, man. That's why he got a great team.
He's doing a lot of positive stuff, man. A lot of positive stuff.
Nice. But when the camera's not on, LeBron is working.
No, he ain't.
He's working.
Man, he ain't doing
that. That's what it's about, man.
No, he eating.
He got a show or something out, though. They doing something on it.
You don't know what the hell going on.
He just sitting back on the couch. LeBron do got a show. He's sitting on. I saw it on Facebook.
Oh, hey, God. Bro. I mean, Cap just pulled a Marshall on it just now.
He's in his thoughts, man.
LeBron ain't got a show out.
Yeah.
All right. So
what's the name of it?
Yeah, I'm asking him. That's Marshall.
I ain't bringing that man show. I don't even know him like that.
Man, LeBron working, man. I respect it, LeBron. But now Zion Williams, man, if he playing US, that'd be great. That'd be great for basketball, man. That'd be great for the ratings, all that good stuff. He'll bring that, you know, especially after his 1 year of college.
The shop. You
know. The shop.
But if he do play, what y'all think? Y'all think he'll dominate like he did in college?
No.
No, you don't think so.
He'll do good, but he won't start.
Yeah.
What would you think? But when he get in, would you think he dominate?
No, he got to work on that jump shot.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. You ain't gonna be able to fly by everybody on this level.
But
I seen somebody do it this year though.
Who?
Greek the Freak.
Well, his name is Freak.
So he put in years.
Yeah, he wasn't like this 3 years ago. Yeah.
Only a couple years. Exactly. But I'm just saying, I watched him
third year, fourth year.
I think this is third.
He put that work in though. He wasn't like this for a couple years.
Nah, he was always dominant.
No, not like this.
Yeah, I mean, this
man with MVP status this year.
I agree.
Say less.
But you know. I want Zion to do good because you know boy from South Carolina. You know.
Tell it.
I want to go out there and ball out.
Tell it.
Dunk on some folks and.
Yep, I'm gonna give me a Pelicans jersey.
Make his mark.
Yo, give me old Pelican.
The thing about Zion, he just doing something that nobody's never done. I mean, at that size, at that height, just, you know, a man above kids out there.
LeBron?
You know,
so.
Zion should go for the big three, man.
Yeah, I like that.
That's what we need, Zion, the big three.
Zion, man, don't worry about the NBA. Holla at Q, getting
the big three.
He hook you up. Word up. 25-year contract, guaranteed. Let go.
Shout out to Zion.
Hey,
go and dominate, bro.
Oh, but he might not be a good 3-on-3 person though.
Yeah, it'd be gonna be 1-on-3.
He might need 5.
And he's just gonna take on everybody.
Spread everybody out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey. The lecture hall.
Yeah.
Lecture Hall. This for all of y'all.
Ooh.
All of y'all. The Lecture Hall. Lecture Hall. Hey. This for all of y'all.
Uh-oh.
All of y'all.
We at Cap.
Yeah. Hey. Closing out.
Yep.
Hey. How we do?
Hey.
All day.
Out of time.
So
no rhyme.
Nope.
We gon' climb.
Hey.
Y'all
hey.
Talk too much on the mic.
Yeah.
Didn't leave space. I bet the camera stopped all in our face.
Gone.
Cause Rich said 1, 2, 3.
Hey, y'all
start the clock, yep. Then the 5, 4. Yep.